Welcome to Yellow Brick Road. I'm Jordan, and today I'm talking about Fox Wars Part 1, Revenge of the Ashkenazi. Sorry. But first, please consider donating to Devin's Journey to Recovery. The GoFundMe link is in the description box. That's right, it's a fucking charity. So I want to hear more bullshit about, oh, your intros are too long. Shut up and donate. Then you can complain. After you donate, you can complain. So yeah, it's charity for one of our subscribers and his wife. Helps them pay medical bills because I guess no one wants universal health care or the guaranteed health care for everyone without piling up debt and, you know, taking out loans or whatever, right? Health should be, like, invaluable because we need more people alive to be more creative. Not jobs. I mean creative, as in adding something to life itself. Something that carries on from the fucking mechanic on the film set to the actor themselves or the director. They're all needed, right? So please donate. Devin's Journey to Recovery. GoFundMe link in the description box. All right. So this guy, Brett Stevens. Oh, did I confuse him with someone else? I think he's a Fox News guy. Am I thinking of Brett Baer? Whatever. This Brett Stevens guy says, Ashkenazi Jews might have a marginal advantage over their Gentile peers when it comes to thinking better. Thinking better? Who knows what the fuck that means. Where their advantage more often lies in the thinking thinking different. Says Brett Stevens. Thinking different. So those are, it's a weird statement on its own. So there's several problems here. I'm not going to go with, he's racist. I'm not going to go full Adam Green or full SJW. Like, this is Jewish supremacy. Or this is identity supremacy. Or whatever the fuck. I'm not going to go there because I'm sure most people will go there. Here's my problem. Is I don't view that as like real intelligence. Right? There's like normal intelligence as in things that robots can have. Like a robot can calculate, you know, crazy numbers and irrational numbers like in split seconds, right? Like your calculator can do shit like that. But that's like a different form of intelligence, right? That's like programmed intelligence, right? So if you're talking about identity groups, black, white, Jewish, Asian, Latino, anything, even like gay, straight, trans, whatever, right? We've seen the alt-right guys go by identity groups and say, the average IQ of this group is blah, blah, blah. Like, that's not actual intelligence. That is what I would call programmed intelligence, just like a calculator, right? There's no practical use because there's no being there using it practically, right? You have to separate yourself from the conditioned ideologies, the conditioned thinking patterns, the conditioned movements. Separate yourself from those. And then you start performing real intelligence, real practical intelligence, right? Because you're using it in your life and you're making your choices. That's real intelligence, right? It's based on how logical or rational your choices are based on you. But if there's no recognition of you, then it's not real intelligence. It's just programmed in. Some might make a case, I would make a case for a mixture of genetic and environmental factors for that programmed intelligence, right? If you're born with half a brain, you probably can't express certain things, right? But that, once again, I think that's a baseline, shallow form of intelligence. You'll see it in kids in the front of the classroom or raising their hands after every question asked. And they're like, oh, I have the answer. I know the answer. Pick me. What's her name from Election? Tracy Flick. Tracy Flick. One of those people. Like, ooh, ooh, me. Because what they're doing is they're memorizing what the teacher said and then regurgitating it later. Right? As opposed to someone who separates and says, why is this important? And then they make their choices. Is this important to me or is this not important to me? Like, oh, I really like cars. So my intelligence, I'll use my intelligence in the realm of being a mechanic or driving or, you know, how cars function. Right? If I don't really care about, you know, cars and its engineering or the mechanics of it, if I don't care about that and I'm doing it anyways, like, someone would just step back like, how fucking smart are you? Like, I know everything about this car, but you don't care about it. So how smart are you actually? You sound pretty dumb if you're doing some shit you don't actually like. So that's the same thing that goes with book smarts. Like, if I'm sitting in class and I'm like, this is boring as shit, and then someone tells me, well, your future is dictated by how good you are at this thing that I want you to be good at. But that's not my thing. So then I don't do this thing. It's like, oh, well, you have a low IQ then. You're not smart. It's like, what? You want me to invest my time and my thoughts on something I don't care about. And you're calling me dumb for doing that? That is an ass-backwards version of intelligence. So, in regards to this little quote here, I'm doing a Stone Cold thing here. This little quote here, you and your little trunks, bring out your little sledgehammer, Triple H. You mealy-mouthed son of a bitch. But, yeah, in regards to this quote here, when he says, you know, it relies on thinking differently. He's talking about it's the environment they grow up in and they're taught to think different and all that, blah, blah, blah. Like, there is no teaching to think different. There's just exposure to differences and the individual starts to decide, like, everything they're telling me, what if the opposite is the case? Or what are the opposites of this thing they're telling me? Is it even opposites or is there just infinity surrounding? And they're trying to force me down this one tunnel when there's like fucking outer space and stars everywhere. So, real intelligence, break that conditioning. If you want to just be head in the book, you know, face planted in a book or head buried in the sand, and you just want to run off your conditioning so that you can, you know, daydream through life. And then once those little actions of your intelligence, like, oh, I became a doctor because my dad was a doctor, my grandfather was a doctor, and blah, blah, blah was a doctor. And they raised me to be a doctor. And you want to just daydream through your doctor practices so you can get off of work and go fucking party or hang out with your family or something. Or it's an excuse to put food on the table. I hear that a lot. It's like, all right, fair enough. But just know that that's not real intelligence. You're daydreaming through it. You're not even really there. Find something you care about, then that's the real intelligence right there. All right, that's it for me. Please subscribe if you like, comment, agree, disagree. Tell me what you think. Am I right? Am I wrong? Is Brett Stevens right? Or Brett Steffens? I don't see a V there. I'll say Steffens instead. Is Brett Steffens right? You tell me. Don't forget to donate Devin's Journey to Recovery. GoFundMe link in the description box. And with all that said, give this video a thumbs down. Say you wanna get him.